The Jeff Dempsey family were neighbors and friends of the Gephards over on Andalusia Drive. And the Gephards later moved to Nashua Drive, where the Bill Dempsey family lived. Paige Gephardt. Paige was Leslie's piano teacher. And Scott remembers, I don't know why this word cute keeps coming up, but the cute little girl who would stop by the house to pick up her piano book. Fast forward 45 years, Megan, Leslie's niece, saw Scott's picture online and encouraged her to send him a like. Which, after great hesitation, she did. And neither knowing that that Scott Gephardt was a family friend from the past, Cousin Val encouraged Leslie to go out with Scott, telling her what a fun-loving man he was. So Leslie and Scott go to dinner at the North End Cafe and enjoy each other's company immediately and immensely. And thus we are here today. And each one of you has been invited to be here this evening because you have been a meaningful part of each of their lives in more ways, they would tell you, than you can imagine. And you have supported them as they have grown deeply in love with each other. They feel strongly, and they want you to know that they feel that they are at this point in their lives making these promises and commitments today because God and this great universe in which we live have brought them to this place where they are today. And so they are committed to living out the rest of their lives loving and caring for one another, as well as accepting each other's families as their own, including, of course, Molly and Norman and Bailey. On this day, since they are spiritual people, they would like you to remember the words from the Bible that tell us that love is patient, love is kind, it does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud, it does not dishonor others, it is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered, it keeps no record of wrongs. They would like you to remember the words of the New Testament that say, do everything in love. And that Jesus says, my command is this, love one another as I have loved you. And whoever, John says, does not love, does not know God, because God is love. And so they find the words of 1 Corinthians 2 very meaningful, when it says, what no eye has seen, what no ear has heard, what no human mind has conceived, the things God has prepared for those who love Him. And so these are words they want to build their relationship around. And it's also words that they want to build their relationship as a couple with you in the days ahead around as well. You know, love is a fascinating thing. And we've come together this evening. We are investing this time together this evening to celebrate and support Scott and Leslie joining their separate lives together in marriage. And we've gathered in the church because we remember that a marriage is a spiritual and religious experience. It's more than just some legal contract that satisfies all the customs and expectations of our society. Marriage is that intimate expression of love, Christian love, God's love. And so Leslie and Scott come together this evening to make a covenant, to make a promise to each other that reflects and is enriched by God's love for them and each of us and our love for Him. So Scott and Leslie, the true love and trust that you are building for each other, with each other, will be a reflection of the presence of God in your lives. And so the words mean something special when the psalmist writes, unless the Lord builds the house or the home, those who build it labor in vain. So I encourage you to pattern your love for each other after the love and care that God has for each of us as His human beings, His creation. And I think that means three things for you in the days ahead. We remember, each of us, that God's love is a caring love. It searches out our needs. And so your love, Leslie and Scott, should not be centered upon your own needs, but upon the needs of each other, upon the needs of your spouse. Marriage is not some kind of contract. You're not making a deal today that demands. You're making a covenant or a promise that shares. Love is not some kind of appetite to be satisfied, but it's an abundance that you give to each other. And that's God's kind of love for us. It's a love that gives and gives and gives and gives. And you are now accepting the responsibility for each other's joy and happiness and success. You're accepting responsibility for each other. And so work hard and give of and from yourselves so that each of you can continue to become even more of all that God has created and needs for you to be. God's love is like that for each of us. His love is secondly also an enduring love. It lasts and lasts and lasts. And so make your love, Scott and Leslie, for each other enduring. Work through hurt.